What the hell?
Hey, how much work?
Ron, why you look like a chocolate baby Huey?
A what?
Why don't you have any clothes on, man?
What's wrong with what our cat want?
Nothing, unless we got a pole in the middle of the floor and playing Busta Rhymes Make It Clap.
It's not funny. Look, why are y'all clowning me what I have on?
Okay, we need to set some ground rules because you running around here jiggling, baby, it ain't gonna work. Rule number one, when you walk out of your room, please be clothed. I don't need no more scary images in my memory bank. Is mandatory. It is not an option. And no, rule number three, no eating my damn cereal. Y'all ain't saying me nothing.
Oh, I didn't know you wanted any.
Why wouldn't I want some? It's my cereal.
Well, I mean, it was sitting up in the cupboard unopened.
Ron, really? I'm not even going to entertain that. Did you drink all my cranberry juice?
I only drank a little bit. I saved you some, though.
Yeah, you saved me a swallow. I just bought this last night.
Well, I could have drunk it all.
You might as well.
That would be rude, Mommy.
Ron, don't you think you should...
Oh, did poor little Juan go potty on himself?
That's not funny. You know what? I'm going to go change because obviously I'm too much man for all of y'all.
Be able to catch up with these bills.
Hey,
what the hell? You scared the hell out of me. And what's wrong with the cabinets?
They ain't got no food on. Who the hell fried the chicken?
My aunt. You eating out of the plate that she fixed Uncle Eddie the day he died.
No wonder he died. You need to clean that refrigerator out because this chicken got a little aftertaste.
Why is it that you can't use the front door like normal folks?
It's because I'm part of the neighborhood watch. And I take my job very seriously. I don't half step. I don't step half. But I do step in the name of love. Groove in the name of love.
Is there any reason to your madness?
You trying to get inside the J-Dub. Notice the trash man ain't been here since your uncle died.
Crap! Forgot to call and set up payment arrangements. I don't know if I could do this.
Hey. Now, don't give up. That's one thing I admired about your uncle. He wasn't worth a damn. But he knew a little something about living with rules. Good guy.
I remember one time you told me right before we fired him. J-Dub, life is gonna pick you up like Bob Backlund. Slam you to the ground like Hulk Hogan. Choke you, get you like Vader. And just when you think you about to rise up, like put you in a chokehold, choke a turd out of you. So don't give up. Things is like a struggle, but it's gonna get better for you. I'm gonna take care of that trash problem for you.
Oh, J-Dub, that's sweet, thank you.
Yeah, I'm gonna just put it in the pearl tray. And that sanitation money, take it to fix them cabinets.
But there's nothing wrong with the cabinets.
I told you I ain't had no food in.
I just thought I'd bring back your trash can since J-Dub here didn't have the decency to return it.
Hey, Miss Pearl.
You saw that?
Yeah. Next time you might want to take the bed sheets from off your head and just slide the trash can over into my yard. You make more noise than her uncle did when he used to sneak out.
Why would Uncle Ed sneak out of the house?
To keep from eating your aunt's bad cooking. He would come over to my house every evening for supper. Oh, by the way, Lucy, you got some kid lurking around here, hurting himself.
What?
Yeah, the first time I saw him ride by, didn't think nothing of it. But then he come back with a grappling hook and he tried to throw it over your house. But it fell back and hit him upside the head. And now he's back there peeping in your windows.
J-Dub, you didn't notice this guy peeping around my house? I thought you said you took your neighborhood watch position seriously.
I do take my job seriously. I was gonna tell you, Jingy McChain.
You didn't say anything.
I was about to let you know you got a handicapped peeper Tom looking through your window.
What? Handicapped?
I know you. Daniel, right?
Oh my gosh, you remember my name. I told my psychiatrist that we were destined to be together.
What you mean, together? Daniel, what are you doing here?
After the interview and we parted ways, I waited for you to come out to your car so I could write down your license plate number and get your address. You know, you're just 120 miles from my house. Anyway, I just needed to make sure that you made it home safely, my love.
Then you can't be lurking around my house like that. You could get hurt or arrested.
I just wanted to let you know that I really like that outfit that you bought yesterday at 7:34 p.m.
Sounds like a nutball to me.
Look, Daniel, I haven't made a decision yet on the rooms.
Yes, you have. Ron and Monique have already moved in. Oh, hey, Monique.
Hey, person I've never seen before.
Hey,
Monique,
you need some help?
Yes, please.
Well, alrighty then. I'll be next door if y'all need me.
Daniel, you can go ahead and leave. I'll contact you and let you know what I decide.
Daniel!
I'm all right.
Girl, check it out. I got a call to be on the show, Get the Dirt.
Ew, I don't even know why you submitted to be on that stupid, ridiculous show anyway. I read that it's just set up to fulfill a basic human need, technically known as downward comparison.
Downward comparison? What is that?
Comparing yourself to someone who you feel is less pretty, attractive, smarter, or socially skilled than you are.
Yeah, okay, so you know how hard it is to get cast, and guess what the topic is?
Your man cheated on me with your best friend.
No, all men cheat the same way.
Denise, you can't possibly believe that all men cheat the same way.
Yeah, my sister's friend's next door neighbor's husband cheated on her, just like my friend's cousin's auntie's daughter Shanta's baby daddy did her. And it was the same way.
Was that even in English? Come on, Denise, you don't actually believe that, do you?
Hey, don't they all have to take their pants off the same way?
Hey, Denise.
Hey, Lucy, guess what?
What's up?
I got a call to be on the show Get the Dirt.
Such a shame.
Why y'all hating?
Girl, ain't nobody hating. That show is just like all the rest of the shows. Messy.
I know, right? She's only out to get the dirt.
Y'all just mad because they didn't call you.
Please. The last thing I want to do is be on that show. Corsica is an instigator. Every guest she has on that show is full of drama and ghetto. And why she always eating?
Girl, guess what? I'm gonna be on Corsica's Get the Dirt talk show!
Really? They called you too?
Girl, yes, they asked me to be an expert on their panel.
Wow. Like, that actually makes sense. So, Mom, why would you want to be on that ridiculous show anyway?
Girl, I love her talk show. Okay, I've been watching her since she started. Girl, she helps people in their time of crisis.
Didn't she get shut down for her last show? What the heck? Who ordered the chocolate bouncer stripper?
And yet another myth destroyed about the way a man takes his pants off.
My bad. I spilled coffee on my pants and I got an audition for a film project in 20 minutes.
So you decide to show us what you're working with?
I'm in a hurry and you're 10 minutes away from the place they're having it at. Hey, Simone.
Hey, Ron.
She's not the only person in here, Ron.
Oh, Denise, tell Ron.
Tell me what?
Denise got a call to be on the talk show. Get the
word. You got called to be on that show? That show is garbage.
I got called to be an expert on the show.
Exactly why I like it now. It used to be garbage.
You know, I love it when you contradict yourself, Ron.
Look, seriously, Denise? Corsica's a head case. I mean, she lives on drama. And her show was shut down because one of the guests that she had on the show found out where she lived.
I'm sorry, it's been a minute. Okay, well, thanks anyway. Okay, bye. Tara, this girl I interviewed for the room.
Well, you got two whole empty rooms upstairs. Why did you tell her it was rented?
Was she the one you was telling me about with the flowers in her head?
They told me at the shop that she gave everybody in there a contact high.
And then Laptor Yonka said that the police was talking to her after she left.
Yeah, you gotta watch out who you rent to these days. There's some crazy people out there. My client Melissa said a guy saw her at a convention and wrote her license plate number down. She hadn't been able to get rid of him since.
I don't get it. Why would he write her license plate number down?
Duh, to get her address. Don't you know how to stalk somebody?
Yes!
What are you so excited about?
Somebody probably told him they cook him some fried chicken and potatoes.
Yeah, if they were holding a charity event entitled Please Feed Denise.
Well, alrighty then. That was Robert Bonstone on the phone, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh my God, what did he say?
I got a call back for Wednesday.
At 4 p.m.?
How did you know?
So I'll be riding shotgun, baby.
Oh, baby. Hey, he didn't call me.
Did you check your email?
How do you guys get all the good gigs?
Well, it's called talent. Something you absolutely have no idea when looking for great projects.
Yes! I'm riding with you guys on Wednesday.
See you guys later.
Brian, wait, you forgetting something?
What?
Your pants to cover up those ashy knees.
See you guys later.
Will you guys come with me?
Come where? To your little show?
Ugh. Do we have to? Because I don't want no parts of that.
Yes, you have to. I could use some support from my friends.
Hello, Lucy. How are you doing without your darling uncle around?
Miss Patty, right?
Indeed, the one and only. Here, hon, I prepared this especially for you. when I returned back to town.
Okay. Yeah, well,
come on, guys. If we leave now, we can beat rush hour.
Oh, Lord. I can't believe I'm going to go see a live train wreck.
Well, see you later, Lucy. You lucky bastard.
So where's that skank?
Excuse me?
I mean your aunt. Where is she?
Aunt Martha Ann is in Florida. Mm.
Oh, yes, of course. She left you alone in this big old house all by your lonesome. And what is it that you say you do for a living again?
Well, I'm a security officer.
All the bills that come with having a house, you can't afford that on a security officer payroll.
I know, but...
You should think about having a roommate. Someone that can clean and protect the house from intruders.
I've already considered roommates.
Well, he'll be here this evening.
What? Who?
My son, Thaddeus.
Whoa. First of all, I gotta interview him. And I don't even know him. Hell, I don't even know you.
Well, if you must know, my son is multi-talented. He's an actor, singer, and he also dances, just like his mother. And from where I stand, you need someone who can continuously pay rent on time.
Pay rent? Continuously? On time?
I believe this should cover it for the next 6 months. I've even included a security deposit.
He could move in today.
I knew I liked you better than that floozy of an aunt of yours. Toodles.
I love your show.
Thank you.
Well, in my expert opinion, I do believe that all men cheat the same way because they crave sexual variety.
Oh, that's
right. See what I'm saying? Men, they desire the variety of different women. Okay? Take my client, for instance. Every time you look around, he has a new girl.
I see. Why don't you enlighten us about this superstar client you have?
Well, you know, Corsica, as a stylist of Simone Du Beauty in Atlanta. Mm-hmm. Yes, but as a stylist, people tell me they're dirt.
Okay.
Yes. So, let's see, this client I was telling you about, he was telling me about his ex-girlfriend and how he cheated on her the same way. I mean, he did it so much it became second nature, all right? And the sad thing is, that poor girl, she just stayed there, stayed with him until she caught him in the act. That's right.
Yeah, that is interesting.
Oh, no. See, listen. Not with one or two, but three girls in his hotel.
No, he wrong.
Three girls.
Now that is interestingly dirty.
Oh, it was dirty, all right. There was one in the closet, one under the bed, and then one crouching under the sink.
What?
And then she stayed with him still. She tried to get him back by cheating on him with someone else, but she didn't know that he knew the guy she was cheating with.
Okay.
And that guy was married.
No.
You don't say.
So, yes. So she was getting screwed all the way around.
Okay.
Literally.
That is some befouled information, Miss Simone. But the baking wouldn't be done if it wasn't cooked on both sides. Why don't we get a male's perspective? Joining us today is Manny, Simone's co-owner, Aunt Barbara. Come on out, Manny. Now, Manny, give us the dirt.
Well, Corsica, I ain't really got no dirt to share. You know, I just don't agree that all men cheat the same. All
right, brother.
Some do want variety, yes, but some are searching for Miss Right. You have men out there like myself that are being misrepresented. I'm not a cheater. I'm a lover.
Manny, Manny, Manny. I can't believe a man with your stature doesn't have any dirt. Well, let's give him some help, shall we? And bring in his ex-girlfriend, Belle!
Yes, okay, so you cheated on me with my ex-best friend at the shop in the men's bathroom. Yeah. I went in there looking for you. What, you can't explain it, you can't.
Come out, I wasn't even cheating. She had a pterodactyl baby on. Okay, I was just trying to help her. I was being a gentleman and I was just trying to assist her.
So how do you explain her being baby number 8, man? Oh. You can't.
Plenty of tries and errors. Wait a minute, but hold on. What about Mike Reeves? The guy you cheated on me with? I didn't know, huh? Yeah, that's right. Yeah, get the dirt on that.
Let's welcome Mike Reeves to the show.
Mike? Oh.
Hey, she told me that she was single, and I don't do OPP.
Just like you didn't tell me you was married.
So Pam, what you're saying is that you found out Mike Reeves was actually married?
Yes.
No, she already knew and she was pushing up on me. That's why I left her alone.
So you trying to tell me that we didn't just come back from Malibu, Grand Prix, together, y'all. And you took me and my kids there.
I thought you said you were scoping out the area with your colleagues.
Yes! This is Shanika Alize, Mike's wife of 5 years. Now, Shanika, did you know that Mike Reeves was cheating on you with Pat?
You know, I had that women intuition, and I started checking things. I checked the emails, I checked the gas mileage on the car, I checked the incoming calls, the outgoing calls, I even checked his Facebook page, I checked his drawers also. Because per sperm count, he only has the 3 kids by us.
So you check his sperm count?
Girl, yeah, you can't never be too careful.
See, that's exactly why I'm single.
You single because I left you.
Hold on. Now, Pam and Shanika, did you know that Mike was cheating on the both of you?
What? With another one?
Viewers, let's welcome the main subject in this dirty love triangle. Denise, come on out!
Yeah. That's that helper's name. Denise.
Hello, Corsica. Honestly, there's really nothing to tell. We went out for about 2 weeks the last time we were together. I noticed he had on a wedding band. I broke it off immediately.
Dang. Wow. You didn't tell her you was married?
Sweetie, I didn't tell her that I wasn't married. I said if I wasn't married. She must have misunderstood me.
Whatever. You probably did tell her that because that's the same thing you told me, okay?
Well, nothing happened between us anyway. After I saw his wedding band the last time we were together, I broke it off immediately. I was only seeing him to make my boyfriend jealous anyway.
And Denise, who were you seeing at that particular time?
Well, his name was Chester Stevens. He was my first boyfriend and was supposed to be my last. He wanted to pursue a career in rap. It just kind of tore us apart.
Chester Stevens? And he wanted to be a rapper? He ain't getting too far with a name like that. Sounds like some type of snack or some Cheetos or something. You know what I'm saying?
Viewers, let's welcome Chester Stevens, a.k.a. Sir Twerkalus.
What? Twerk a lot? Wonder why she got issues.
Yo, what's up, everybody? What's up, Denise, Simone, Corsica?
So Denise, you dated Sir Twerk a lot?
Yeah, until he cheated on me.
Well, I get it now.
Oh, Niecy, come on, you still on that? Look, we dated, it was alright, but you couldn't get me on my rap game. And now I'm with someone who got me.
That is not what happened.
Well, Denise, tell us what happened exactly. Give us the dirt.
What are you eating?
Really? And why aren't you sharing? Pass that, please.
Pass it around. Pass it around.
Well, I went to one of his shows in Savannah, Georgia to support him in his career. I catch him backstage, tongue-locking with one of my clients.
With mine. Viewers, let's welcome Sunny Skies to the show!
Damn!
Like, OMG. I am like on a real talk show, baby. Look, she even have a real desk. Like that Lenny guy that work on the late night show.
I know, babe.
Come on,
sit on down. There we go.
And this the girl he cheated on with Denise? This is the girl he cheated on with Denise? This is one lucky ass dude.
What?
Poor Denise.
Look, Pearl, you are spoiling me with your cooking.
Yeah, Miss Pearl, I'm already spoiled.
You know, your uncle used to say that very same thing to me, but it was my other cooking he was talking about. He loved to see me shake and bake and rock and roll.
Hey guys, how's the show? You guys all right?
Well, you were right about Corsica.
Whoa! Everybody all right?
Yes! What the hell, J-Dub?
Had something to tell y'all.
What?
I smell food.
Really, J-Dub? Anyway, I have some news, Ron and Monique.
Hey, I hope it ain't like that news Denise got. Corsica had you looking like a piece of toilet paper. You was on a roll at first, but towards the end, you was taking shit from a butthole.
What happened?
Well, Corsica basically made a fool out of poor little Denise.